Welcome to TimeBeat Breaking News Channel. Here are our breaking news today.
1. A retired FBI agent has been charged with defrauding a woman of $800,000. 2. Kidnapping raid in Nigeria, gunmen steal children from an Islamic school.
Texas. A retired FBI agent has been charged with defrauding a woman of $800,000. A retired FBI agent in Texas has been charged for defrauding a lady out of $800,000 by telling her that she was on hidden probation for drug offenses and that she needed to pay him and an accomplice for their work, mentoring, and supervising her. William Roy Stone, 62 years old, who had retired from the FBI's Dallas field office about a month before the fraud started, even proposed marriage to the woman and claimed he would attempt to get her off probation. Mr. Stone was indicted by a grand jury on Tuesday on 7 counts of wire fraud, 1 count of wire fraud conspiracy, 1 count of impersonating a federal officer, 1 count of engaging in monetary transactions in property derived from unlawful activity, and 1 count of making false statements to law enforcement, according to prosecutors. Mr. Stone faces up to 178 years in prison if convicted of all charges, according to the United States Attorney's Office for the Northern District of Texas. Prosecutors disclosed only a few details of the plan that they allege Mr. Stone perpetuated for more than 3.5 years in a statement announcing the allegations and the 15-page indictment that was unsealed last week. Prosecutors did not respond to phone and email queries left with them on Sunday evening.
Nigeria. Kidnapping raid in Nigeria, gunmen steal children from an Islamic school. A group of armed bandits shot and abducted students from an Islamic school in the north-central Nigerian state of Niger on Sunday, state police claimed in a statement. In the most recent round of school kidnapping raids in the country this year, at least one person has been reported dead. The actual number of kids abducted from the Salahu Tanko Islamic school is unknown, according to Yaro Al-Hassan, the school's headmaster, but more than 150 are still missing or unaccounted for. Security agencies' efforts to achieve their release have been stepped up, according to Niger State Deputy Governor Ahmed Mohamed Ketso, who spoke at a press conference on Monday. "We never pay ransom to kidnappers. We're attempting to work out a plan to get them back to us safely," Ketso stated. In response to the constant attacks, Ketso claimed the government has temporarily converted all Tajina region schools to day schools and ensured that every primary and secondary school has a security response team. The authorities had contacted some parents of the identified kidnapped children to ensure them of their children's safe return, according to Ketso.
Thank you for watching. We help you stay up to date all the news hourly. Please subscribe our channel to follow up the latest one.